Oh, you know what? I admit it. At first, when I found out you were Rachel Clark's daughter, I sort of wanted to run in the opposite direction. You know, have nothing to do with you.
Then maybe my moving back here wasn't such a good idea.
But, however, I kind of gave it a lot of thought, and I realized that's very silly. I mean, look at you. You're you. You're not Rachel. When I look at you, you aren't Rachel. You're just a nice person who is a little lost and confused right now.
But it still means that you have to deal with seeing Chris and my mom. I know that's not easy for you, and I don't want to have to put you through that.
Well, I admit there's no love lost between your mother and me, but I'm a very big girl. I can handle it.
It's not easy knowing everybody hates your mother.
I don't hate her. I don't. I mean, you know, it's... Yeah. See, what it is I look at her and I just cannot possibly trust her. She always looks like she's up to no good.
The person everybody knows in Port Charles is so completely different from the person I've known my whole life. When I was little, I used to climb every tree I could find, and it drove my mom crazy, but she let me do it. She wanted me to take risks and learn how to protect myself and be strong. I was never scared, because no matter what I did, she was always there ready to catch me.
Okay, so what do you think changed? How did that happen between you and your mother?
Well, when she came to Port Charles. That's the first time we had spent any real time apart. And that's why I came here, because I missed her. But all she wanted was for me to go home. But she was here, so that made it home.
Did she ever tell you why?
At first, I thought it had something to do with my Aunt Grace's death. Then I figured it was because the father I thought was dead lived nearby. Only now, it turns out he's not even my father at all.
If you don't mind me asking, who is?
According to my mother, just some one-night stand. I don't know. Maybe that's the big secret she didn't want me to know. Hello?
Libby, it's Kevin.
Hi, Dr. Collins.
I was just wondering if you'd remembered anything else since our last session.
Not a thing. But I'm sure glad you called. Just hearing your voice helps.
I'm giving Ramsey 10 minutes tops.
Settle down.
I've got a John Doe in the ER. He's stable now, but I'd like to be with him if he goes sour.
Look, everybody can get back to their patients as soon as I find out which one of you this is about.
Oh, don't tell me you're taking that trash serious.
The story had to come from somewhere.
Whether anyone here is HIV positive or not is irrelevant. We're good doctors. We take care of our patients and ourselves.
Such
That's
righteous.
If we're not in here listening to your rubbish.
Righteous indignation, Dr. Thornhart. Is it you?
It's none of your business.
Well, as chief resident, I think it is.
You know what? Why don't you just get that tattooed across your forehead, Ramsey? So that way we don't forget.
You know, there is no way Alan is behind you going on this witch hunt.
Yeah. I mean, that's ridiculous. The only thing you want is to satisfy your morbid curiosity. That's what's going on
here. Look, I'm partially responsible for running things around here, and this situation is creating chaos. So I want to know if it's true.
If it is true, that means that one of us could be infected. Okay, so maybe you could be a little more sympathetic or sensitive.
Yeah, like talking to each one of us privately, one-on-one.
Look, we can do this any way you want, as long as I get an answer.
Well, you're not going to get an answer from me.
I will, unless you want to work the graveyard the rest of your stay.
And look, it's me. All right, the resident in that article is me.
Joe, you don't have to do this.
Don't give him the satisfaction.
I've been exposed to the virus, but I tested negative twice.
That's really good, Joe. That means your chances of becoming infected are way down.
As a colleague, I appreciate your candor. Maybe your patients would feel the same.
What? You're not going to go public with this, are you?
No. Of course not, but I'm going to make sure the media and everyone else around here knows it's not me.
Hey, how's the guy?
No change.
Oh, do you know who he is?
Now, I've seen him somewhere before, but I can't come up with a name. Anyway, Dr. Scanlon's gonna do everything he can.
Thanks. Hey, you can take off. All right, I'll stick around, make sure he's okay.
Well, I'm not leaving.
Hey, you don't have to act all tough. I know what's going on inside a little head of yours. You know, it had to freak you seeing that guy lay there like that.
Well, there's all that blood. God, who would want to do something like that? You know, hurt somebody that can't even fight back.
Cedric, are you mean?
You know, I used to think that basically everybody was good. But look at me, you know, I'm a killer.
Oh, come on, that's bull. You didn't kill Cedric.
I am the one who pushed him down those stairs. I am the reason for that happening.
You were fighting for your life, all right?
It doesn't matter. No, I know that, but I still can't forget it.
All right, sorry.
No, it's not you.
Yeah, it is. You know, all this coming out like this makes me see the truth.
What truth?
You're never gonna forget this as long as I'm around to remind you. I mean, come on, Spunky, let's face it. It's time we go our separate ways. Now, if I was gone, then the memories would be gone too.
Yeah, well, what if you're wrong? What if the memories don't disappear and then I'm left with nobody who understands what I'm going through?
You got lots of folks. Look, you got Dr. Collins, you got Eve, you got your grandma. I mean, me being around is just causing you a bunch of pain, all right? And that doesn't do either one of us any good.
You know, you're always threatening of leaving, but you never do. Because you know that we belong together.
Allie, this is not like the other times. All right? This is real.
No. We are what's real. Okay, what you and I feel for each other, that is what's real. And that's all that matters.
Yeah, if you're reading those sappy stories and those novels that you're reading. This is the world, Allie.
Then we'll change it. God, you are such a coward and a quitter. I hate you.
Good. Good, so you won't be calling me and you won't be dropping by either. All right? You can just go back to hanging with your old pals and kicking it by the pool and shopping and dancing and going back to a life that was meant for you.
Look, I don't want that. I don't want them. I have nothing to say to them. That is not my life anymore.
You're not talking me out of this, Allie. Look, trust me. All right, it's the best thing for both of us. All right.
How's our John Doe?
His vitals are back to normal, but he's still disoriented.
X-rays show a cerebral contusion. Hairline fracture along the back of the head.
How was your meeting?
I told Ramsey the article was about me.
Whoa!
Yeah, I figured the other residents were dealing with fallout, you know? They deserve to have the facts.
Oh, if I ever find out who gave that story to the Inquisitor, you will have another patient with cerebral contusions.
Listen, Gabby, this is more than you signed on for. Are you sure you're up for it?
Does that answer your question?
Joe, I like the way you handled Ramsey.
Oh, thanks. Oh, listen, thanks for backing me up in there.
Yeah, well, hopefully that story will go away now. Tell me about this John Doe you've been treating. What's he look like?
I don't know, mid-40s, red hair, you know, disoriented. Why?
Well, he might be my missing patient. Excuse me. Well, hello there, Mr. Green. Now, where the hell have you been?
You know, I actually can relate to maybe a little bit of what you're going through. I never knew my father either.
I know my family's history is connected to my dreams, and my dreams are connected to my Aunt Grace's death, but I don't know how. I'm gonna find out, though, with Kevin's help.
So what do you think? Do you really believe that this therapy thingy is going pretty well? Is it working?
Yeah, I've learned a lot of stuff. Like Kevin knowing my Aunt Grace.
So he told you that, huh?
Yeah, he thought I should know. I guess any information helps. I was only about 3 when she died. That's why I had Kevin hypnotize me, to remember that part of my life.
That's good. You know, sometimes hypnosis does work very well for people. I mean, you think it helped.
I remembered so much stuff. Like, when I was little, I was on my mother's lap, and she would sing me my favorite lullaby. And just the smell of her perfume. And I remember playing with this pretty ring on her finger. And it was all blue and had these sparkling little diamonds around it. Gosh, I wonder whatever happened to that ring. Mom hasn't worn it in all these years.
This thing is going to contaminate the whole hospital.
It already has. Ramsey just interrogated all the residents.
On a rumor?
No. The resident mentioned in this article is Joe.
He's HIV positive?
No, he's just been exposed. And he's been tested twice, and he's been negative twice.
Good.
Yes.
Good. Well, I hope he doesn't let this rag get him down.
Or that jerk Ramsey. So, why were you looking for me?
Well, I don't want you to forget what I look like.
Something is going on in that brilliant mind of yours.
And I wish I could share.
Oh. It's about Libby? Yeah, okay, I'll take that as a yes. Look, I know you feel obligated to her. I know that. But it kills me to see you this troubled.
It kills me to feel this isolated.
Isolated?
From you.
Oh, honey, I'm just this far away.
Oh. Well, maybe I should reach out more often, then.
Maybe both of us should.
Hey. Guess who showed up in the ER?
What? Mr. Green?
Yeah, he's found unconscious in an alleyway. Paramedics brought him in.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, I'll go take care of him.
Don't mind me. Go ahead and go. Just let me know if I can help.
Okay, we will.
Thanks.
The color of the sky at night.
And when the light hits it just right, it pulls in all the stars. I want to watch the stars with you forever. Marry me, Grace.
Kevin, hey, wait up.
Hey. Oh, how's Mr. Green?
Oh, not good. He's weak and disoriented.
Sorry to hear that. If there's anything I can do, but it sounds like his problem's more physical than psychological.
Well, listen, if Ian and I manage to pull him through this, we may take you up on your offer. In the meantime, how about dinner?
Are you kidding? I thought you'd be tied up for hours.
No, I told Ian that I wanted to spend some time with you.
And I just told Gail that I'd take care of one of her patients.
Well, can you cancel your... Never mind. I know the answer to that.
I can see you at home later.
Yeah. But don't forget to eat. Okay, because I know you on a full schedule.
Thanks for the concern.
Well, it's just a natural byproduct of this husband and wife thing we've got going.
Speaking of going...
All right, go.
Lambert.
Yeah? How's Mr. Green?
His fever spike's been moved up to 6.
It's probably septic because of the IV being ripped out.
Yeah, probably. We'll know more later. I was just paged to the ER. Could you...
No problem. Kevin's busy. I'll check on him.
Thanks. I hope he recovers enough to tell us how he ended up unconscious in an alley.
Okay, so you're absolutely positively sure you're going to be okay alone here?
Yeah, after my session with Kevin, what I need most is some time alone to think.
Yeah, that's good. I just wish there was something I could do for you.
I just hope you know how much it means, Lucy, having such a great friend like you.
You have a lot of good friends, you know, so just hang in there and you'll be okay here, right? Right?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
Okay, well then, ta.
Okay.
Okay, hang in.
Sorry, it's not Lucy.
So am I. I have nothing to say to you.
So you give Lucy hugs. But the woman that raised you for the last 18 years, you're gonna slam the door in my face?
I'm sorry, I don't have any time for this.
Well, then make time, Livy. Don't you think I deserve that?
Where is he? Where's Neil?
He's upstairs. Why?
Bring him down here. I am taking him home with me right now. I just read that article in the National Inquisitor, and we all know who it's about, don't we?
My heart goes out to you, Joe. It really does.
What heart?
But I am not going to put Neil's life at risk by allowing him to live under the same roof with a man who's carrying the virus.
For God's sake, Courtney, Joe being exposed is hardly news to you.
Well, this changes everything.
The papers are wrong. I'm not HIV positive. I had my six-month test.
Oh, 6 months? That doesn't guarantee anything.
If there aren't any signs in that amount of time, the odds are about 1,000% better it will never show up at all. So at least be happy for Joe before you start making trouble.
I'm happy, but this is public knowledge now. And what is it going to do to Neil when he finds out that his hero had casual sex with an infected stranger? It is such an outrageous example of bad judgment.
Spoken by the queen of bad judgment.
Don't you dare.
If Neil needs an explanation, I'll take care of it myself.
He has already had enough pain.
Everybody around you has had enough pain, Courtney, because you can't make it through a day without whipping up a nice big batch of it. When the hell are you going to figure out that you don't have to make the rest of us miserable to protect Neil?
Ian!
Hey, I was going to come find you as soon as this chart's finished. How's Mr. Green?
On the usual antibiotics. His infection's running wild.
Well, I hope his fever breaks soon. I want to start him on that enzyme protocol that we talked about.
Don't you think that may be risky? I mean, he may have been getting treatment from someplace else.
Yeah, well, I ordered another tox screen. And I called all over the state trying to find out about that hospital ID bracelet.
Oh, any luck?
No. What about you? It's good to talk to the man.
He's very out of it. I don't know if it's from the fever or from the infection itself.
You hungry?
Yes, I am.
Oh, boy.
But not for this trail mix. What?
It's an old war injury. It's nothing. It's fine.
Oh. Well, maybe I can help. You know, I have been told I have magic fingers.
I'm
here,
fine.
Let me
I'm just...
Stop being such a thornheart, all right? Save being a pain in the butt for another time. That's what you're really good at, you know. And medicine. Oh. And poker. You're really good at poker.
Mm-hmm.
Great. How's that feel?
I'm sorry.
It's my fault. I'll try again.
All right.
You know, I mean, I hate being out of the loop. Especially when it's something really important. And you really need to discuss these things. But it's personal, or, you know, it's about a patient. It's ethic related. I don't know. I know he's a shrink, but still.
We're not talking about me or Mr. Green right now, are we?
Why is it men can't deal with the fact that some people are just concerned about them? Really concerned about them? Why is that? Tell me why.
Okay. And why is it so hard for women to see and hear what the men aren't saying?
Excuse me, what did you say?
That's funny. I mean,
No, I'm serious. I heard what you said. That's great. That's it.
Where are you going?
Thanks, Ian. See ya.
Glad I could help.
Hey.
Hey.
I don't need an invitation these days, do I?
No, of course not. To what do I owe the pleasure?
I don't know. I thought maybe you could use the company.
Cause?
No reason, really. Just, I know about your session with Livy.
Oh, she told you that, did she?
Yeah, she did. See, this is a good thing because it cuts through all that confidentiality thingy stuff, and we can just talk if you want to talk.
You're the best friend a shrink ever had.
Okay, Doc. Then listen, just why don't you put your head in my hands and tell me what's going on, because I get the feeling it's not just about Livy's nightmares.
It isn't. You know, the dreams, I can handle the dreams. It's what I know about Grace and the rest of her family.
Then why don't you just tell Livy?
I can't. The whole point of her therapy is for her to discover the truth in her own time so she can deal with it.
I know that, except that a lot of people in Port Charles already know that, you know, you were engaged to Grace and you were with Grace the night she drowned.
You really think I should tell Livy all the details?
I do, before somebody else does, like Chris Renby.
Chris could do some damage, but the one I'm worried about is Rachel.
We're always worried about Rachel.
Rachel has gone out of her way to keep Livy away from me, but she hasn't used the one piece of ammunition that she thinks she has. She believes that I'm responsible for Grace's death, but she hasn't said one word to Livy.
Livy, I know there are problems, and I made mistakes, but we've got to talk through them.
So now you want to talk?
You mean the world to me, and you know that. And the way that things are between us right now, it's tearing my heart out. Your grandmother's too.
So now you know how it feels.
Look, Can't we get past all this?
I wouldn't know how.
Well, maybe I do. Livy, there are things that I've kept from you.
Oh, really?
Things that you need to hear.
Don't worry, Joe. This won't take long. What's the matter with you?
Come on, Frank. You know everything I went through trying to get Neil well again. So how could I not be worried about him living with someone who has a contagious disease?
The only one sick around here, Courtney, is you.
Me?
You are so worried about HIV being a threat when you are 10 times more destructive.
How can you say that to me? You saw everything I went through.
I saw someone back then, but it wasn't you. I saw an incredible mother. I saw a woman so full of compassion and love that I couldn't help falling in love myself.
So what happened to us then?
You. What happened to you, Courtney? Well, I don't have an answer for that, but I do know you are not the person you were.
You know, it's funny. Because I think you're the one who changed, not me. But I guess we'll never see eye to eye on that, will we?
On that and a lot of other things.
Okay. Well, you go ahead and rewrite history all you like, okay? But I will have my son back with me. Trust me on that.
You sure do seem to be drinking a lot of that stuff lately.
And you could at least pretend not to notice.
Yeah, right.
It's just this whole situation, Lucy, is a lot more complicated than I let on.
Okay, think about this. Who has been in more complicated situations than me?
Nobody.
Right. And who has solved more complicated situations than you? Nobody. So together we should put our heads right together and come up with a solution to this problem.
Oh, just that easy.
Yeah, Doc, just that easy. Come on, you always tell your patients that you have to talk and talk and talk and talk until you get to the bottom of something. Well, that's what we do. Trust me, we'll do it. We'll solve this problem. And I really believe it'll probably be the best thing.
Best for whom?
For you and for Livy.
You know something, Lucy? I really am a lucky guy to be able to talk to you about these things.
You know what? You are very lucky. And you can talk to me about absolutely anything.
Anything.
Anything else. Anything. Anything.
The only thing I want to hear from you is why.
Why I kept the truth from you about your father.
It's as good a place as any to start.
Well, believe it or not, Livy, that and every decision that I've made...
Not for my sake.
It was to protect you.
You wanted me to leave from the minute I got here, and I want to know why. But I want the truth this time, Mom, all of it. And I mean that.
I know, I know you do. And I promise no more. No more secrets.
You say you wanted me to leave because you didn't want me to find out Joshua Lack wasn't my father. But I say there's more. And I think it's got something to do with Aunt Grace somehow.
You're right. It does. You see, when your Aunt Grace died...
Drowned, you mean?
When Grace drowned, something happened to your grandmother, and she's never been the same.
Yeah, I know that.
No, what you don't know is it's gotten worse. And I've been keeping it from you because I know how much you love your grandmother. I couldn't bear to see you go through the same kind of pain that I've been going through. Livy, you have no idea what it's like to watch someone you love slipping away. And now it's happening again with you. You're just slipping away. You're the one thing that I really thought I did right in my life. I need you more than any other person in the world.
So why didn't you just let me in? I might have been able to help.
No, help me at your expense, and I wasn't going to let that happen.
So you just sent me away?
Yes, I did. But out of love. No other reason. And that's my only defense. It was to save you from so much pain.
It's all right. Come here now. We can help each other.
Where's Courtney?
She's gone, but she'll be back. What about Neil?
Earphones on. Just about to break through to level something on some video game.
Good. At least he didn't hear how ugly a guy down here. She won't give up. I know that look in her eye.
I know it, too. And when I saw it, I started thinking.
About what?
Well, somebody had to let that paper know about a GH resident who might be HIV positive.
Yeah, from the way she was using that story to try to get Neil, I would bet my last penny on it being her.
If I could just get my hands on that self-serving...
I know, man. I know what you mean. But the only problem is we don't have any proof that she's the one who made the call.
There's got to be a way to get some proof.
Are you okay, Dr. Lambert? Yeah, of course I'm okay. Why?
Third time you've given me the same orders in 2 minutes.
Really? Oh, I'm sorry, Marcella. I guess maybe I just need to take a nap or something.
Good idea.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
I'm looking for Dr. Borgman's office.
Is that the food he ordered?
Number 5 combo with egg roll?
Yeah, it sounds just like it. But wasn't there some kind of a tragic accident tonight? Something about pirates stealing a number 5 or something?
Yeah. Kim ran out of nowhere. Pistols and peg legs and all.
Yeah, you were helpless. Nothing we could do.
And Borgman's a lousy tipper.
I thought this was empty.
Ian! Wait a minute. Is that a number 3?
The number 5 combo with egg roll.
Close enough. What happened to the trail mix?
I had a craving for mushu something with noodles and mushrooms and what looks like chicken. Dad, you want to share this with me or not? You said you want some real food.
You ordered dinner for me. That's so sweet.
Didn't exactly order it. I hijacked it from your friend Boardman.
Boardman? Oh, my God. Do you know what happened to the last doctor who pulled that stunt?
I do not.
Nothing. He never found out it was me. Come on, let's see. Thank you.
That's mine.
Most beautiful girl in the whole wide world.
And you're the most beautiful mommy in the whole wide world. I'd close my eyes and smell that wonderful smell. Like we just finished bath time. Your hand gently stroking my hair and you'd sing that song you'd always sing. Sing it again for me, please. Come on, you remember it.
Yeah, it was just a long time ago.
Please. Just a little bit for me.
Yeah, sure.
Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Mama's gonna buy
you. No, that's not the one.
Olivia, that was over 15 years ago. I sang you a lot of songs.
But the special one.
It's really sweet that you still have so many special memories of growing up as a young child. Now I look at you and I still see that perfect little girl.
Now that we have everything out in the open and settled, we can spend more time together. We can make a million more memories.
Okay, so you said complicated. What does that mean, complicated?
I didn't think you were about to let that one go by.
No.
Have a look at that.
Wow. That's gorgeous. You know, I think I've seen this ring somewhere before. It's a sapphire, right?
Sapphire and diamond.
You know, Livy described a ring that her mother used to wear on her finger that sounds a lot like this one. Wow, she described it perfectly.
Kevin Collins. Well, this is a bit of a surprise. What time tomorrow? All right, I'll be there.
Doc, what was that about?
That was Livy's grandmother, Estelle.
That's weird.
What's weirder still is I was planning to pay a visit to her.
Why?
Because I have some questions.
Like, were they questions about this ring? I have a question for you, though. How did you get this ring if this belongs to Rachel? How'd you end up with it?
Lucy, that is the ring that I gave to Grace for our engagement.
Wait. If this is the ring that Livy saw on her mother's finger, then why in the world would Rachel be wearing her sister's engagement ring?
That's just it. She wouldn't be.
Doc, are you thinking what I'm thinking? That if this is the same ring, and Livy saw it on her mother's finger, maybe her mother's not Rachel. What if her mother is Grace?
Ready?
Yes. Show him in.
Hello, Estelle.
It's been much too long.
You know, I was just thinking the same thing.
Today's high news.
What a goal line stand by the Flyers. An incredible defensive performance.
Aren't you gonna say anything?
Yeah, what do you want?
Well, I just stopped by to pick up some earrings because I thought I might have left them here.
Oh, I haven't seen any earrings.
Well, that doesn't mean that they're not here. I mean, they are pretty small, only a quarter carat.
We have some trouble?
No. Just the outfit needs a little breaking in, that's all.
Oh, yeah, no, I can see that.
Well, I just bought it today for a very big date I've got tonight.
Oh, you got a date.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. So who's the guy?
Nobody you know.
Try me. What's his name?
His name is Chandler.
Oh, Chandler.
Yep, he's this very cute, very rich guy. Who's been after me since, like, freshman year, so...
Right. Chandler, isn't that the name of that guy on that show that you always watch?
So? There can't be more than one Chandler?
All right. I guess there can.
What? Are you jealous?
Please, hell no, I ain't jealous.
Good, because, you know, you're the one who said that we should just move on, so...
Yeah, so I'm happy for you. Yeah, do it.
I will.
All right. Hey, what's up?
Nothing much. Just dropped Neil off.
Not at Courtney's.
Oh no, at a friend's. But he was talking about her a little on the way over.
Yeah.
Yeah. He still doesn't want to live with her, but he's kind of worried.
What about?
Her being all alone. He's afraid she might be mad at him for bailing out.
That's great. That's just great. She hasn't done enough to the kid. Now she's gonna make him feel guilty? Hey, don't tell me you're backing off.
No, I want him to be here. You know that. I can tell He misses her, that's all.
Frank.
No, I'm only saying, in spite of all of the rotten stuff Courtney has done, the one good thing about her, and probably the only good thing, is how much she loves our son.
Well, I still think he's better off here.
Hey, bro, turn it up.
Also coming up on our evening news, an exclusive interview with the insider who leaked the story of General Hospital's HIV-positive resident. And part two of our special feature on fad diets, health and fitness guru.
Guess we'll find out who to thank.
Here we go. Half mushroom, half anchovy. This for you.
Dig in.
What's the matter? Not hungry?
Yeah, I am.
Why aren't you eating? Huh? Did you come to your senses and realize that little fish that look like eyebrows don't belong on pizza?
Yeah, I thought you were this big gourmet.
Oh, I am. It's just a place for anchovies, you know? Like in a Caesar salad or a nice puttanesca sauce. But pizza? Ooh.
Well, I like them.
And why aren't you eating them?
I don't know. I guess I'm a little distracted.
Still thinking about that visit with your mother?
Yeah, it was pretty strange.
How? Did you get any of those answers that you've been looking for?
She just did her usual double talk in circles routine. Except she did open up about one thing.
What's that?
Why she didn't want me in town.
Really?
Yeah, it's because of my grandma. She's getting worse. A lot worse.
I'm sorry to hear that.
I felt bad for her, though. I mean, I'm glad she told me because I was totally starting to freak a little.
About what?
My mom and I were having this moment, you know, we were kind of connecting. It was nice.
And?
It was almost exactly identical to this memory I had the other day in a session with Kevin. A memory from my childhood.
Well, of your mother?
Yeah, when I was sitting on her lap and she sang me my favorite lullaby.
Only what?
Yesterday, when I asked my mom to sing me the lullaby, she didn't even remember it.
Not at all.
She sang the wrong one. What is up with that?
Wish I knew.
Or am I just making a big deal out of nothing? I mean, you can totally tell me if I am.
Given everything that's happened lately with your family, I think you should trust your gut.
Really?
If it's telling you something's wrong, maybe it is.
Can I get you a cup of tea?
No, thank you.
I'm sorry I don't have more to offer, but I do appreciate you coming.
Well, the truth is, if you hadn't asked me, I would have come on my own. You and I have a lot to talk about, don't we, Estelle?
Oh, I love that tune. Do you like it? The big band sound?
Why, yes, I do.
Oh, it's just my favorite. Oh, you know, I used to dance with my girls to this. Oh, yeah. They loved it, too. Just like I did. You know, Glenn Miller, Tommy Dorsey, all of them.
Really? You know, Grace never mentioned that to me. But then she never talked about her family very much. She did tell me that she had a mother and a younger sister. You know, I'm certain that she never, ever mentioned Livy.
Oh, well, Gracie was very protective of Livy. We all are.
You don't find it odd that she never once mentioned her niece to her own fiancé?
I don't find it odd at all. Well, that's enough of the music. Now, I think that we ought to talk about why I asked you here.
I know why you asked me here. You want me to stay away from Livy. Do you know why I wanted to see you?
You know, I couldn't begin to guess what is in that head of yours.
I want to know why Livy was kept a secret all these years. I want to know why first Grace, then you and Rachel, never said one word about this child that you claim to love so much to anyone.
Well, look around. There's not too many places they could be hiding.
Fine.
And, by the way, definitely return all that stuff that I spent days picking out for this dump.
Look, I already told you I wasn't keeping it.
Fine. Live in an ugly apartment, see if I care.
Well, you won't have to look at it after today now, will you?
No, I won't. Excuse me.
You know, Allison, I don't remember you taking off your earrings. Ever. When exactly did you say you lost these things?
Oh, look, turn this up. What? I want to hear this. It's about that HIV narc over at GH. It concerns my career.
Oh, your career, huh?
Okay, my job, whatever. Turn it up.
On our evening edition, we'll be talking to the General Hospital source who, to protect their identity, requested we conduct the interview in silhouette and alter their voice. Stay tuned for a WLPC exclusive with this brave citizen. But now, let's go to Randy in our traffic copter.
Please, a brave citizen? How brave do you have to be to hide in silhouette?
Well, which doctor's positive, do you know?
No, I don't have a clue. But I heard it was just one big lie anyways. But turn that back up, because I want to hear this interview.
Oh, come on. You got plenty of time before the evening news. Of course, you can go, you know, catch it with your date.
Well, aren't you just in a big hurry to get rid of me? What do you have, like, big plans or something?
You know, kicking around a few possibilities.
Yeah, well, while you're kicking around a few possibilities, my date and I will be dining at Mario's by candlelight.
Oh.
And then dancing until we drop at Luke's.
Good. It's about time you got out and had some fun.
Totally.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look. There they are. Ouch. See, they were... Look. They were here the whole time. Oh.
Oh, so is that what you meant by, kind of breaking it in?
Look, it's really not that big of a deal, okay? My seamstress can sew it up in a second. Plus, you know, Chandler likes me in revealing clothes.
Well, I wouldn't reveal, like, too much. Unless you want to get arrested. Here, put this on.
No, I'm fine, thank you.
Look, would you just tie this around your waist? Please.
Fine. Is that better? Are you happy?
Yeah, just, you know, just looking out for you, that's all.
Yeah, well, I don't need you looking out for my butt anymore. No pun intended.
All right. So now you got your earrings and everything, so... wouldn't want to keep Chandler waiting, you know? Chandler?
Well, actually, it's okay. He really doesn't mind. I already have him eating out of the palm of my hand.
Oh, okay. Great. Mm-hmm. I'm sure you two will be very, very happy together.
Yeah, that's the plan.
All right.
Excuse me.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Bye.
You know, speaking of Kevin, he's become protective of you.
What did he say?
Well, he just wanted to make sure my intentions were honorable.
That is so funny. Kevin and Lucy are trying to protect me from you. My mom is trying to protect me from Kevin and Lucy. You're the only one not telling me to shut anyone out.
It's because I know how much you care about everyone.
Well, I just wish they knew how much I cared about you.
That's nice of you to say. Of course, I can understand where they're coming from. I mean, they care quite a bit about you, and... unfortunately, every time they look at me, they see Julie.
That is so unfair.
Yeah, well, life's unfair.
Do you think Julie's the reason that my mom and grandmother hate Kevin so much?
Is that what Kevin said?
Well, when I asked him, he just said that it was inappropriate to talk about himself in our sessions, and that if I wanted answers about myself, I'd have to find out on my own.
Well, personally, I might think the animosity toward Kevin is about Julie if it were only Rachel. But your grandmother hates Kevin, too. She never met Julie.
Wait a minute. What about Aunt Grace?
What about her?
You think it had something to do with the fact that he knew her?
Livy, there's something you should know. Rachel and your grandmother tried to stop Kevin's wedding.
They what?
And I've always believed that it had something to do with the fact that Kevin knew Grace.
Do you know why I tried to stop your wedding?
Well, obviously it had something to do with revenge, because you believed wrongly that I was responsible for Grace's death.
No, you're the one who's wrong. I did it out of love for Gracie. Because there you were, moving on with your life, while poor, sweet Gracie was lying in her grave, utterly forgotten. She deserved more than that.
Actually, I haven't forgotten her, Estelle. As much as I'd like to, those are memories that I'll never escape.
Well, you look like you're doing just fine.
Well, looks can be deceiving now, can't they? Which brings me back to my question, which I notice you still haven't answered. Why was Livy kept a secret?
I don't have to answer your question. You're a murderer, and I'm glad that you're being haunted by Gracie. You should be haunted by her every minute, every day, for the rest of your life.
Forget your medication today, Estelle?
No, I'm just fine. I'm fine. No thanks to you. All right, okay. Now, you want to rid yourself of Gracie? I know how to do it.
Stay away from Livy. Forget it.
You think you are so high and mighty, don't you, Doctor? That you can do whatever you want, and no one can touch you. Well, you're not going to get away with it. Because Livy is wonderful and sweet and loving, just like Gracie. And you can't destroy her the way you destroyed my daughter.
How you and Rachel raised a child as sweet and unaffected as Livy is beyond me.
Don't you dare talk to me.
You know, on the
like
way
that.
Over here, I actually wondered if working with Livy was a good idea. But I can see now more clearly than ever that she really needs my help.
Kevin, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. I don't know why I did that. I don't know where all that came from. The fact is that I really would like to take a stab at ending our disagreements, once and for all.
We are talking to the person who has the inside scoop on what's going on behind that veil of secrecy at General Hospital. First of all, can you tell us the name of the doctor who is HIV positive?
I could, but that's not what this is about. I'm here solely to alert the public that this person is working very closely in potentially high-risk situations with people who are already weak and vulnerable, and this includes innocent children, who should be our primary concern.
Now, General Hospital claims that none of its patients are in any danger from the doctors working there.
Of course they're saying that, but are you willing to take that kind of risk for yourself or for your family? I know I'm not.
Thank you for talking to us today.
I felt morally obligated to do so.
I'd like to emphasize again that there have never been any cases of an HIV positive healthcare worker unintentionally infecting a patient.
What a circus. I'd sure like to know who the hell that was standing in the shadows.
There's only one person it could have been.
So, how did I do?
Well, not bad, if you want to create mass hysteria.
Oh, I wasn't trying to scare anybody. It's just that I'm a mother myself, and I will do whatever it takes to keep our children safe. I'll take a slice of your cheeseless.
For here?
Yeah, why not? Got no other place to be except home with Banana.
I find that hard to believe.
Oh, no, it's true. Keep the change.
You're a doc.
Yeah, thanks. At least somebody thinks so.
Sorry, I should have told you about this wedding thing sooner.
Well, why didn't you?
I wasn't there, you know? I'm not one for rumor and innuendo.
So then why now?
I thought any little bit of information I could give you would help, but I can see it's only upset you further. I'm sorry.
So why did they do it?
What, try and stop the wedding?
Yeah.
Well, from what I heard, it had something to do with Kevin knowing Grace. But like I said, I wasn't there, so anything I tell you is secondhand.
But there were lots of other people there, right?
Half the town.
Boy, am I gonna love watching my mother squirm out of this one.
Please, excuse me. I mean, there was no excuse for that behavior. I don't know, it's just so hard. Being here and locked up and away from all the people that you love. I mean, Libby is really the only one I have left.
You have Rachel.
She's too busy for a doddering old woman like me.
Estelle.
I didn't mean to fall apart on you like this. Could you do me a favor and just get my Hank Heath in that dresser and top drawer? It's way in the back. And it has a little embroidered flowers on it.
Did you find it?
Still looking.
Let me see if I can't help you.
You know, Estelle, if you're gonna try and kill me every time you see me, you might want to work on your subtlety.
You monster! You're not gonna get away with it! You're not gonna get away with it! Oh, my God.
Dr. Lambert, what are you doing here? I thought you had the night off.
Yeah, I did. And I was all curled up and settled in with a nice new mystery until I realized that I could not get the one here out of my mind.
The case of Mr. Green.
Exactly. Are you updating his chart?
Working on it. You'll read it tomorrow.
Well, I figured that I could just lend a helping hand tonight. I mean, in case somebody calls in sick.
Or...
what?
Well, where's your husband tonight?
Working here.
And is that the reason why you left the comforts of home?
Doc? What are you looking at? I was so glad when I got your message saying that you wanted to see me. I wasn't sure. After last night, you know, how you would feel. But I've got to tell you, for me, sweetheart, it's like a dream come true. Just to sit there and hold my baby again and sing her a lullaby.
Who are you?
What?
I just found out that you and Grandma tried to stop Kevin's wedding. Why? Why do you hate him so much?
I told you why I'm here.
The book you were reading was boring and you wanted to come see a patient. That doesn't add up.
Okay, fine. My popcorn popper broke.
Your popcorn popper?
Yeah, you can't expect me to sit at home without my garlic and onion popcorn, can you?
Oh, heaven forbid.
Okay, smarty pants, so why are you here?
Let me see if I got this right. My name is Ian, and I'm a workaholic.
Hi, Ian.
Hi. I've got under control. I took a whole day off.
When? 3 months ago? That's the last time you saw daylight.
My home and work are too far apart. So I would be driving back and forth polluting this beautiful autumn air when I could save the environment.
Mm-hmm. By what? Camping out in the on-call room? I think you're taking this tree-hugging thing a bit too far, don't you?
Hey. If the tree doesn't mind, I'd have a problem with it.
Okay. Here's one for you. Let's say this is hornet, thick, huge hornet, buzzing around my head, ready to go in for the dive bomb. Do I swat it and kill it? Or do I let it sting me because it has feelings?
I've yet to meet a hornet that would want to harm you.
You're ducking the question.
Speaking of hornets, since you're here, would you want to stir up some trouble with me?
You all right?
No. Did you see that trash on TV?
I just want to protect the children from the HIV-positive resident.
Please. It's bad enough the tabloids are printing rumors. Now the liar who started it all gets a spot on the 6 o'clock news?
Yeah, whoever it is.
A coward. That's who it is. They had to disguise his voice and cover up his little rat face.
Are you sure it's a he?
Why, you know differently?
Yeah, I have an idea.
Oh, Courtney.
See, Frank and I are pretty sure. But we don't know how to prove it. She's good at covering her tracks.
Well, then you stop hunting her. You let her come to you.
What, set a trap?
Yeah, absolutely. Just figure out what to use for bait.
Well, that's a no-brainer. Money.
Okay, well, then money's what we'll dangle in front of her.
We?
Well, it doesn't hurt to have a willing partner, does it?
No, not at all.
Okay, so where do we start?
Run an ad in the paper?
Okay, not bad, not bad. Of course, we could just go the direct route.
Yeah, which is?
Two boxing gloves and a glass jaw.
Cat fight, huh?
Oh, it would not be a fight, believe me. Okay, it would be a slam down. You just give me the word and Courtney is toast. What? You don't think I can do it?
No, I do, I do.
So then why are you laughing at me?
Because you're awesome, you know? I mean, give me a break. Can I help it if I love you?
Fine then. You think plan A is stupid? Right, me kicking some major butt, so we'll just go on to plan B. You know, put an ad in the paper. What should we say? Oh my gosh, is that Grace, finally?
That's right, you've never seen a picture of her, have you?
No, I haven't. Wow, she was beautiful. Where did you get this photograph?
From Estelle.
So you did actually go see her?
Well, I was hoping she'd be clear enough to give me some answers.
Was she?
Charming one minute and ranting and raving the next.
So Estella actually gave you this picture?
No. No, I saw it in the bureau. Thing is, Lucy, that is exactly the image that Livy remembered when she was under hypnosis, being held by her mother.
Except in Livy's mind, her mother is Rachel. This picture is of Grace.
Holding a beautiful little girl and wearing the ring that I gave her. I see that picture and the next thing I know, I'm slipping it into my pocket.
Doc, I think this means...
I don't know what this means. No, I don't know what this means, Lucy. Maybe Grace loaned Rachel that ring. And maybe what Livy sees in her dreams isn't actually a ring. It might be symbolic of something else. Dreams play that game. They hide one thing after another.
Doc, could this be more proof? Could this be more proof that maybe Rachel is not Livy's mother, and maybe Grace is? Why did you and Grandma try to stop Kevin's wedding? The only thing that makes any sense is if it's because Kevin knew Aunt Grace.
Well, you know what? This is the problem that I have with Kevin. Because you're a patient of his, he thinks it's therapeutic to upset you, to alienate you from your own mother, even if it means bending the truth. Well, that's unprofessional, Livy, and highly unethical. That's a part of Kevin that he likes to hide from everyone. But your grandmother has been on to him for years, and that's why she warned you about him. Don't you see that she is right?
Do you know how totally paranoid you sound? Like what you did at that wedding, some big secret, Kevin Blad?
Well, how else would you know?
Come on, Mom! The whole town knows about it.
But Kevin,
he never once ever said a word to me, never even brought the subject up. His only concern was my well-being. I wish I could say the same about you.
Honey, you can.
No, Mom. It's all about you these days.
That's not true.
You lied to me over and over again.
I was protecting you, Livy.
You kept me in the dark with my nightmares. That was protecting me? You wanted to stay in control, and a scared little girl wouldn't ask any questions. Well, I've got one more question and we're done. Does it bother you even a little bit to know that you are a horrible mother?